Hi, it's Marco Van Basten. This is a short revisit on the last video in relation to making stainless steel mesh wicks, either for your Vision Ego Clearomizer or Stardust Atomiser, or in fact for any other mod that you can use a stainless steel mesh wick on. I've had a couple of questions, and they're mostly, can you make curved stainless steel mesh wicks without creasing the stainless steel? And the answer to that is yes, you can. I won't take you through the entire process this time. If you want to see how to make one, look at the video on my channel. But you start off with your square of stainless steel mesh. This is 400 stainless steel mesh. You wrap it around your paper clip, until you have got it rolled. And then it's very simply a case of bending the paperclip. And this is one that I've already done. So as you can see, I've bent the paperclip round. And you can make this, you know, as big or as small as you like, the curve. This will eventually be going onto my Ego Vision when I get some spare tubes arriving. So we'll go ahead and we'll make this like we would up until the point where you put the wire on the coil, and then I'll show you. The other difference is I'm going to show you a slightly different way. From the last video, I quenched in the water four times and then I dripped on some juice and burnt that. This time what we're going to do is we're going to heat it and quench in the water four times. But then we're going to heat it and quench in some VG. And this is just plain VG that's been diluted at 10%. So it's not 100% VG, it's 90% VG, 10% deionized water. You can use VG, you can use PG, you can use any old juice you've got lying around, unflavored preferably. So we'll just go ahead and I'm going to put this on a pair of tweezers because it's going to get slightly warm. And we'll go ahead and we'll burn it again. Again, I'm using my chef's torch. The bottom comes off, but there you go. So the idea is we are heating this till it glows to get some layers of oxidization. So then when we do build our coil, it doesn't short out because obviously the stainless steel up until this point has been conductive. So that's heat one. And we'll just quench that. Let's move this out of the way for a second. Just letting the excess water drain off there. And then we'll do it again. And we're going to do this a total of four times. And this is, again, so we can get a good layer of oxidization. You will find that once you've quenched it in the water, it will take slightly longer to heat up and glow red because you have to burn off the excess water first. So that's twice. We'll quench that. Again, just soak off the excess. And the third time. I've been making quite a few of these recently. Straight ones, but I thought we'll just do a curved one as I'd had the question asked. So that's the third time. So one more time in the water. You can do this where you do one half at a time and hold the other end. I just prefer to do it all in one go, holding with either a pair of tweezers or a pair of pliers. The ones that you can grip on and lock them, they're quite good. So that's now four times. So we'll just dry that off slightly. Move the water. Excuse me. And now we're just going to do the same thing again, We're doing this three times now, but this time when we have heated it, we're going to dunk it in the VG to quench. And again, this is another way so you don't have to drip it on and have it all spluttering at you. So there we go, that's one. And we'll just soak off the excess. This will probably splutter a little bit. And it does. It's a nice blue flame on it as well. So that's the second time of asking. So this is going to be the final time we do this. And again, once it's burnt off the first bit of VG, it'll start to glow. And hopefully without setting my fire alarm off. Okay, one last quench. And there we are. That has now been quenched four times in water and three times in VG. Now let's dry that off. Now what you do is build your coil. You'd build your coil in the normal way, but you'd put the coil obviously in this area here, and then once your coil has been built, you simply remove the paperclip very carefully, and it will come out. You just need to do it carefully, otherwise you'll bend the stainless steel mesh again. So pair of pliers, grip the other end, and just very gently start bringing that paperclip through, which I have just done. There we go. So now we've got our bent stainless steel mesh. Give it a go. It's like I said before, not that difficult. Happy vaping.